Children, today we are going to learn the construction of similar triangles. Construction of similar triangles, in the sense, first you have to learn what is similar triangle. Similar triangle means two figures are said to be similar if every aspect of one figure is proportional to other figure. The sides are proportional, then we say that they are similar triangles. Same size, but the shape is same, but the size is different. Same shape, but different size. Okay, they are similar triangles. Sisters in the same house, they are looking same, isn't it? They are similar. The size is different, but they are same shape. It is called similar. Okay. Now we have to construct a similar triangles. Example 4.10. See this example 4.10. Construct a triangle similar to a given triangle PQR with its sides equal to 3/5 of the corresponding sides of the triangle PQR. Here given, one triangle PQR is given. We have to construct a triangle of the ratio 3/5 in the ratio. The scale factor here is 3/5. That means given triangle is 5 times bigger triangle, you have to construct 3 times bigger triangle. You have to construct a smaller triangle. Given triangle is 5 times bigger triangle, you have to construct 3 times bigger triangle. Okay, children. So first you have to draw one rough diagram. Rough diagram is you have to simply draw one triangle. And name it as PQR. We have this one is 5 times bigger triangle. We have to construct a smaller triangle, that is 3 times. So it is smaller than this one, isn't it? So you have to draw parallel line for QR and name it as P dash and QR dash. Okay. Therefore P dash QR dash is the 3 times smaller triangle we are going to construct. First you have to draw one bigger triangle. In the measurements are not given in the problem, so you have to draw any measurement. You can 5 times means you have to draw a big triangle. So according to your wish, you have to construct a big triangle. Then only it is easy for you to construct a small triangle inside. This triangle is PQR. Then at Q, you have to draw one acute angle. That is X. QX. We can mark it as X. Okay. Then in the scale factor, 3/5. The greater number is 5, isn't it? So you have to take small radius in the compass. Take small radius in the compass and make 5 arc. 5 arc in the acute angle line. So small, you have to make small arc in the QX line. Okay. So we can draw 1, 2, then 3, 4, 5. We can draw like this arc on QX and name it as Q1. This one is Q2, Q3, Q4 and Q5. Why we are taking 5 arc in the ratio 3 by 5. The greater number here is 5. So 5 are. Now you have to join this 5, Q5 and R. Q5 and this R you have to join. Then you have to draw one parallel line at 3, because the numerator here is 3, isn't it? So at the Q3 you have to draw one parallel line for Q5R. In the Q5R parallel Q3 la or line varayanum. How to draw that parallel line? You have to take any radius, any small radius in the compass, and draw an arc like this. Okay, children, you have to take one small radius in the compass and a Q5 as center and draw the arc like this. Then don't change the radius, same radius. Q3 also you have to draw the same arc. Okay, now take the angle. This much is the angle formed at Q5, isn't it? Take this angle in the compass. So this much angle will be there, isn't it? Take this angle in the compass. And at this cutting point, you have to draw one arc. Okay, children? You can extend that line also. Q3. See this one. You are cutting this point here, isn't it? The meeting point of the two arc is here. So you have to take this angle and cut at the previous arc. So this arc you have to cut it. Then this Q3 and this cutting point, this point and this Q3 joined with this line. So this point is R dash. Now again at R dash you have to draw parallel line to PR. Same way you have to draw one arc at R. Small radius in the compass, draw an arc like this. The same radius, don't change the radius. R dash also, draw an arc like this. Then take the radius in the compass, take the angle in the compass, this angle, correct angle, accurate angle you have to take in the compass, and cut in this previous arc. Understand, children? Now this R dash and this point, R dash and this point, you have to join it. So this you name it as P dash. So P dash Q R dash is the required similar triangle of PQR. Do you understand, children? P dash Q R dash is the required similar triangle of PQR. That is the answer. Next example 4.11. Construct a triangle similar to a given triangle PQR with its sides equal to 7 by 4 of the corresponding sides of the triangle. 7 by 4, here the scale factor is 7 by 4. So that means the given triangle is 4 times bigger. You have to construct 7 times bigger triangle. So given triangle is 4 times, that is smaller triangle given. You have to construct 7 times bigger than the given triangle. Okay, children? So again you have to draw one rough diagram. How to draw the rough diagram? see this one small triangle, you have to draw like this. And the small triangle is given, isn't it? So for this small triangle, you have to name it as P, Q, R. And for the big triangle, you have to mark it as P dash. And here it is R dash. Okay, children? So first you have to draw one small triangle. The measurement also not given. So you have to draw one small triangle. Here we can draw it here. Small triangle we can draw. And name it as P, Q and R. Then at R, at Q, you have to make the acute angle and extend it as and mark it as X. Then in this scale factor, which one is the greater value? 7 is the greater value, isn't it? So you have to take compass and take small radius in the compass and make 7 arc at QX. 7 arc you have to draw. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We can make like this 7 arc on this QX and name it as Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5, Q6 and Q7. You have to join. The given triangle is 4 times is given, isn't it? So you have to join this 4, Q4. This Q4 with this R. Join Q4 and R. Now we have to construct a parallel line to Q4 R at Q7. Q7 la namo oru parallel line varayanum. Parallel line varayanumna we have to extend this line. We can extend this line QR. Okay, children? Then you have to draw the parallel line. So how to draw the parallel line? You have to make small radius in the compass and Q4 as center. Draw an arc like this. Same radius, Q7 as center, Q7 as center, same radius, draw the arc. Okay? Here you have drawn arc. The same radius you have to Q7 as center. Q7 la irundhu adhe mari arc cut pannu. Now you take the angle at Q4. Indha angle idhila irundhu cut panni idhila mudiyudhu illaya. Andha angle correct ah measure panni edukkanum. Eduthu indha arc la nama cut pannanum. Indha arc la andha angle cut pannanum. Seriya? Now இந்த Q7ஐயும் இந்த கட்டிங் பாயிண்ட் ரெண்டையும் ஜாயின் பண்ணி நம்ம அந்த லைனை எக்ஸ்டெண்ட் பண்ணணும். இது வரைக்கும் எக்ஸ்டெண்ட் பண்ணி இருந்தணும். இப்போ இந்த பாயிண்ட் தான் ஆர் டேஷ். ஓகே, தென் வி ஹவ் டு ட்ரா ஹியர் ஒன் பேரலல் லைன். ஸோ வி ஹவ் டு எக்ஸ்டெண்ட் திஸ் லைன். இந்த லைனையும் நம்ம எக்ஸ்டெண்ட் பண்ணி வச்சு விடுவோம். சரியா? Then, இதில் செய்தது மாதிரி அங்கேயும் செய்யணும். யூ ஹவ் டு ட்ரா ஒன் ஸ்மால் ஆர்க் அட் ஆர். ஆரில் எப்படி ஒரு ஸ்மால் ஆர்க் வரைங்க, அதே மாதிரி ஆர் டேஷ்லேயும் அதே ரேடியஸில் ஆர்க் வரைங்க. சேம் ரேடியஸ், ட்ரா த ஆர்க் அட் ஆர் டேஷ். சரியா? தென் டேக் த ஆங்கிள், தென் டேக் த ஆங்கிள். இந்த ஆங்கிள் எவ்வளோன்னு பாரு. அதே ஆங்கிளை இந்த ஆர்க்கில் கட் பண்ணுங்க. சரியா? நவ் யூ ஹவ் டு ஜாயின் திஸ் ஆர் டேஷ் அண்ட் திஸ் பாயிண்ட். ஆர் டேஷையும் அந்த பாயிண்ட், இந்த பாயிண்டையும் வச்சு இங்கே ஜாயின் பண்ணிக்கோங்க. this point is P dash. Now P dash Q R dash. P dash Q R dash is the required triangle. Required similar triangle of PQR. That is the answer for the second example. Children, you draw these two examples, okay?